Ladies and gentlemen, you can have a special meeting of Borough Town Council on Thursday, September 22nd, 2016, at 7:00 p.m. in the auditorium of Borough High School, 425 East Avenue, Harrisville, Florida, within the town of Borough. Present all council members, with the exception of Kim Weaver Seth Brown, who has been excused. Reference to Invenergy Thermal Development LLC's application to construct a Clear River Energy Center property in Borough, Rhode Island. One, consider an act on a motion to adopt a resolution opposing Invenergy Thermal Development LLC's application to construct a Clear River Energy Center property in Borough, Rhode Island, and authorize Council President John F. Pacheco III to testify before the Energy Facility Setting Board and to present the position of the town of Borough and approve the council president's testimony as presented to the town council on September 22nd, 2016, and as it may be amended. I entertain a motion to open.
So moved.
Motion is second, all in favor?
Aye.
The proposed resolution is as follows. Borough Town Council, resolution opposing the siting of the Clear River Energy Center in Borough, Rhode Island. Whereas on October 29th, 2015, Invenergy Thermal Development LLC filed an application to construct the Clear River Energy Center power plant in Borough, Rhode Island, with the Rhode Island Energy Facility Setting Board. And whereas, in the months since the filing of that application, the town of Borough has conducted extensive study on the application with and through present credential professionals, including studies of noise, water, traffic, and air quality, among others. And whereas, after considering expert testimony and conducting thorough public hearing, the Borough Planning Board and Zoning Board of Review have advised the EFSD that Borough, Rhode Island is not a suitable site for the Clear River Energy Center. And whereas, the Borough Building Inspector and Borough Tax Assessor have also submitted advisory opinions to the EFSD expressing the impact the proposed Clear River Energy Center would have on the town of Borough. And whereas, during the past 11 months, many citizens of the town of Borough have expressed clear opposition to the siting of a Clear River Energy Center for reasons including the impacts on property, environment, water, and traffic. And whereas, the Borough Town Council joins with the citizens and officials of Borough expressing concerns and objections to the siting of a Clear River Energy Center in Borough, Rhode Island. Now therefore be it resolved that we, the town council of the town of Borough, do hereby oppose the siting of a Clear River Energy Center in Borough, Rhode Island. Be it further resolved that Borough Town Council President John F. Pacheco III is hereby authorized and directed to testify before the siting board to express the opposition of the town to the siting of a Clear River Energy Center in Borough, Rhode Island.
Motion to adopt the resolution before we continue.
At this time, I am going to give all the fellow council members an opportunity to speak. Councilor Seth Brown, obviously isn't here, but she did write a statement, and I'm going to ask the town clerk to read it to the record.
To John Pacheco, council president from Kimberly Rosette Brown, dated September 21st, 2016, regarding Borough Town Council proposed resolution opposing the siting of Clear River Energy Center. Dear Council President Pacheco, I wanted to thank you for the opportunity to provide my statement supporting the grounds for my opposition to the siting of the Clear River Energy Center in the town of Borough. At the time that the September 22nd, 2016 special meeting was scheduled, in order to comply with filing deadlines set forth by the EFSB, I had previously scheduled a commitment which was made known to my fellow council members and the administration a couple of months ago. This is through no fault of the administration or the council that we were forced to convene in a special meeting to discuss and vote on matters that have the utmost profound effect on our town at a time when not all council members were available. But rather, the scheduling reflects one of the most tantamount flaws concerning the consideration of the CREC application. There is simply not enough time afforded under the EFSB application process to accomplish a thorough and transparent evaluation of this project. A cursory review of what little information has been provided by Invenergy in its application yields only one conclusion. This project is not suitable for our town. In a normal major land development project, the primary consideration has always been whether the applicant can demonstrate that the proposed project complies with local ordinances, the town's comprehensive plan, and state law. Amongst other considerations, if an applicant is seeking an exemption from local zoning ordinances, it bears the burden to establish that a hardship exists through no fault of the applicant and is not a result of the desire to realize greater financial gain. It will not alter the general characteristics of the surrounding area or impair the intent or purpose of the zoning ordinance or comprehensive plan, and it is the least relief necessary. This is not the typical major land development project. It is the most significant development project our town and the neighboring local communities will face in our lifetime. This is compounded by the reality that Bartlesville already hosts a 560 megawatt power plant, Ocean State Power, TransCanada. The town of Bartlesville is described as a rural community, most known for its abundant open space, pristine lakes, woodlands and hiking, biking, hunting and fishing, and glorious scenery, according to the town website. The town planning board has rendered its advisory opinion concluding that the CREC proposal is contrary to the economic development objectives of the town, specifically its efforts towards balancing locally sourced jobs with natural resources and historic preservation and its long-term land use plan, which promotes the conservation and economic development of its natural resources and tourism potential, preserves open space resources, and the low density character of the community. In addition, the opinion recognized that this project could adversely impact the environment and is inconsistent with the comprehensive plan and the Rhode Island Comprehensive Planning and Land Use Regulation Act. The application was filed almost 1 year ago. When the EFSB issued its scheduling order, EFSB hearings were expected to conclude in December 2016, with a final anticipated decision sometime around February 2017. To date, the town has filed 18 data requests to Invenergy, and they still have not identified a water source for this project. Furthermore, at present, the compressor station associated with the Algonquin gas line already presents a significant nuisance to the quiet use and enjoyment of the area by the neighboring residents. The additional noise associated with the construction phase of this proposed facility, along with the increased traffic, wear and tear on local roadways, environmental impact, and air quality concerns, and the failure by Invenergy to sufficiently acknowledge and address these concerns, outweigh any purported benefit of increased energy source or revenue to the town. As such, I strongly offer my opposition to the siting of the proposed Clear River Energy Center by the EFSB. Signed, Kimberly Brissette Brown.
Having studied the opinions of our zoning and planning boards, and as well as the opinions of most of our experts, and the opinions of the other groups that have been asked to weigh in with the Energy Facility Siting Board, at this stage I would say I am strongly opposed to this plan for the following reasons. My most serious concern is the water issue. I think that the aquifer that we have, and as we face the dryness of this season, I think it brings into closer view how serious water shortages can be. To have a company that may, and we don't have enough information to know what kind of water source they are going to end up with, nor do we have time to evaluate their choice, given the time frame of the EFSB, and given the fact that any adverse effect to the aquifer could, in future, strongly affect any town redevelopment issues, any new growth in the town. I find that it is much too dangerous to place the plant at this time. Furthermore, I would note that both DEM and the Department of Health have evidenced some serious reservations about a number of issues that Invenergy has yet to address. I honestly do not believe that even a 30-day extension is going to allow for time to receive answers to all of the pending issues that are out there and a full evaluation of them. So I'm strongly opposed to this.
Thank you, Mr. President. You know, when this council convened back in 2014, I think most of us got onto it expecting to do what we all set out to do, which was to improve roads, improve quality of life in this town for ourselves, the residents, and our friends and neighbors. None of us expected this possible sighting to take place. It's clearly the largest land development proposal that this town will ever see, and perhaps the state will ever see in many years to come. I think you know, the time that we've given our experts to compile the data requests, and I wish I could as articulately re-express what Councilwoman Brown said in her letter, and I don't want to repeat a lot of what she said, but through the data requests that we've submitted, through the work that our experts have done, through the work that some of the state experts have done, it's clear that the application has an incredible amount of shortcomings. And we can talk more and reiterate what Councilwoman Binn said about the water. Water, of course, is a tantamount concern. I myself, as many of the residents here, lived through the Pasco MTBE situation 15 years ago. We know how critical water supply is, not just to Pasco, but to the town. The fact that Invenergy has requested 30 days, I don't know if they got 60 or 90 days if they're going to find an adequate water supply. I found the work that our experts did through the planning and the zoning boards, as well as the work that they've done with our tax assessor and with the administration in general, to be commendable. I found although there were some disturbing things raised in some of the state opinions, DOHs and DEMs, I found those to be rather lacking and disturbing at the same time. Burrville has been the home to two energy facilities for decades. We've done our fair share, and we didn't ask to have another power plant sited. I would again commend the administration, the council, the townspeople here who have become short-term experts on a lot of things that they never expected to become experts on, as a lot of us have also. So with that, I strongly oppose the siting of the plant also, and would support your efforts at the EFSP to make that case. Thank you, John.
Lifelong outdoorsman, environmentalist, strong advocate for open space. I live in the Buffalo area, spending probably greater than 1,000 hours or more hiking, enjoying open space, woodlands up there. This proposal once was proposed for Ocean State Power, this location. It didn't work then, it's not going to work now. So therefore, I oppose this application also.
With everything that's been mentioned. I also agree with a lot of experts with all their, everything that they've, you know, investigated. But I also have my own concerns because I do work for a program during the day with children with special health training, and they have very significant health problems. And some of these children do live very close to the Ford power plant. And I also work part-time as a nurse at San Marino Hospital, and I have concerns about an evacuation plan and if we had some type of hazardous material spillage, various things. It makes me very nervous how we get these patients out in a timely manner. So I could go on and on, but pretty much I think everyone here has already covered a lot of this stuff, and I also want to say I oppose the proposed power plant.
Thank you.
Again, I don't want to echo, well, I do want to echo all of the numbers, et cetera, on this plan. It just doesn't belong. It just doesn't belong in this site. It doesn't belong because of traffic concerns. You can't get to it safely. It doesn't belong because of the destruction of the resources that are going to be up here, the trees, the wetlands, the wildlife. It just doesn't belong. And we don't even know completely what it is because the application is so incomplete. And that is the foundation of our board's primary opposition to this project. We just don't know what it's going to be. And based on the way this company has done business up to this point, their interactions with this town, that worries me more than anything else. And I join the rest of my councilors in strongly opposing the siting of this plan in the borough.
Just a couple of quick notes. I think I was remiss because I haven't done this yet on the record. But I want to make the point to thank the planning board and the zoning board and the tax assessor's office and Joe Raymond and the town manager for the job they've done getting us to this point.
In all of
it.
Nice try.
Obviously, at least it is to me, that a siting board and Invenergy would certainly never say that we did not follow the process. Wholeheartedly agree with everything that's been said by a lot of people in this room over the last few months and by my fellow councilors. So at this time, I would entertain a motion to adopt that resolution.
Make a motion to adopt the resolution opposing the siting of the Clear River Energy Facility in the town of Pearl.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. All in favor? Aye. Second, all in favor?
Aye.
I have one follow-on motion. I make a motion to immediately send this resolution to all the cities and towns in the state of Rhode Island, as well as the cities and towns in Connecticut and Massachusetts, which also will be impacted by construction of this facility, and request their support of our opposition. You folks have kept this in the forefront of Rhode Island news, and everybody up here has heard everything that you have said, and just want to say thank you to each and every one of you.
All right, let's keep it up, folks.